I think I might go do another zone first, because there's two paths to Lost Bastille, and I might as well check them both out first. So how are we doing on upgrade items? Let's see here. I have one more Titanite shard, so let's go ahead and buy five more. It's good to upgrade your weapons. Let's see. So buy five for 4,000 souls. We still have so much left over after this. Oh, required 3 out of 5. Oh, it requires 5. Oh, it's going to require 3 of my current 5. Oh, I misinterpreted something. I saw the next rank of shard and thought it was the normal Titanite shard, but it was like a large Titanite shard. So I needed to buy one more. There we go. Oh, large Titanite shard, because I already have one. I can upgrade that one. Okay. It's probably worth doing. All right, so we'll upgrade one of these to next rank. So one does 172, one does 161. Getting nice, powerful swords. There we go. Let's take a look at that weapon I got earlier. Are they in the right hands right now? They're not. Let's make sure they're in the right hands first. Rapier plus 4 should be in the right... I think there's a benefit of having the stronger weapon in your main hand, but I'm not entirely sure. Anyway, this is the fire longsword, by the way, that I found earlier. Just so you guys can see it. I found it in that cave where there was just the salamander shooting fireballs, and I had to go risk my life to get it. It's not a bad early game weapon. I already upgraded past it though, and I don't know. If you're going strength, it could be a good option, or if you had any reason to have higher fire damage for some reason. But my setup was a little better off without it. So I've got these really scary high damage rapiers now, and the hag is here now. Once you talk to her enough, she will then teleport here as soon as you defeat the last giant boss, and then rest at a bonfire. Do I have any... I have no more souls to spend. These are all boss souls. I'll hold on to them, because I might decide to get something, although I often don't, in which case I might consume them. So we're going to go ahead and level up, because we have so many materials with which to do so. Just to spam and figure out real quickly, let's just see how many times I can level. So we're at 30 right now. Oh. I can level 10 times right now. That's a lot of leveling. So how much can I increase my damage, for example? I can increase my damage by 12 at the cost of 10 levels. If I increase my dexterity all the way to 36 this early in the game, that's probably a bad idea. Let's do a couple points to do adaptability. Get some vigor for some hit point increase. That's 7 points down. We'll put the last 3, I think, into dexterity. There we go. A little more well-rounded. I gave myself... 130 hit points, about 3 damage, and I gave myself some adaptability, which increases your agility, I believe it's called. Yeah, my agility increased by 3, my poise increased by 0.3. Agility is handy because it increases, it affects some animation durations, and it affects some, aside from animations, it affects, what do you call it, your roll a bit, I think. I don't think it makes the roll faster. I think I remember hearing that what it does is it makes your roll move farther or something. Anyway, we have leftover souls, and I don't want to accidentally fuck up and lose them. So, let's stock up. There we go. This is a regular ritual for me after I level up, is I'll often go ahead and just buy some more life gems. Because they're handy to get a supply of. Later on, they'll often just drop at a rate you don't have to actively supply yourself with them. But right now, I've been running low, partly because it took me a few times to do the Pursuer. So we're gonna go back to Hades Tower of Flame, but instead of dealing with all the dangerous shit going on in there, we're gonna head towards the next area and see what happens. I feel like the Pirate Zone's a place where they could do some particularly nasty stuff. This is another character. She's the, Lysia is kind of, eh. She's not really important for the most part, but she's she's the cleric trainer in this game, so she has the holy stuff, and when you talk to her, you get a feeling of the fact that, like, she's a religious leader, supposedly, and a miracle trainer, but she's also, like, just kind of spiteful about the whole thing. She's just kind of a bitch, it's like, I didn't think I'd have to deal with people and their stupid problems, or something along the lines of that, and so she's just petty. And sooner or later, she's gonna actually charge us money to proceed through the game, because that's the type of person she is. What a great religious example. Good for you, lady. Going up in the world. Hello, friend. So you were always here. Oop. Just dodging out of the way of that. There we go. Uh-oh. Oh, cool. So he so I didn't do enough damage to do half his health in one hit, so I shouldn't have been able to kill him in two hits. But this weapon does thrusting damage, I believe, and he started doing an attack. Oh, Soul of the Proud Knight, that's 2,000 souls right there. Hold on to those for later. So a cool thing about thrusting attacks is that if you hit somebody with a thrusting attack while they're in the middle of an attack animation, it counts as a counter-attack. This is a mechanic that's not explained very much in the game, I don't think. But if you do a counter-attack against somebody, I think it does 50% or 30% more damage. There's a boss that actually... There's actually a ring you can get. Oh, he's new. Hello. There's a ring you can get that actually increases your counter-attack damage with thrusting weapons. Very handy if you're going to use a spear. Was this always... Oh, this is the normal way to go. We'll check the other direction really quick, because there's a weird little... There's a knight guy. You don't normally see one of these guys here. He's originally from Dranglake Castle. I don't think you see him until Dranglake Castle, meaning practically the end of the game. Or not the end of the game, but the second half of the game at the very least. So he's nasty because he got a big gross spear attack. And a big asshole. Oh, he tracked like crazy with that animation, didn't he? Parry, motherfucker. That's right. You pay. You pay for your sins. How dare you lay a hand on me? Okay. What were you guarding? A chest. Well, it's in the chest, besides maybe a trap. No trap? What's in you? Sublime Bone Dust, awesome. That'll increase the power of my Estus Flasks. I think that's new. I don't think that used to be in that particular spot before. That's probably why they had that NPC guarding it. Originally, the local Sublime Bone Dust was dropped by one of the first giant guys you fight in Hades Tower of Flame. And it looks like they moved it here. And scarred by a unique enemy, so that's neato. It's a nice little bit of design. This is a pretty linear, not very important zone. It's the gap between No Man's Warf and Hades Tower of Flame. You'll see this a few times throughout the world of Dranglake in Dark Souls. There's just areas where they didn't really seem to have a way of elegantly binding the zones together. So instead, what's this say over here? You lied to me. You lied to me. You lied to me. Instead of when they often can't bind the zones together in any sort of, like, meaningful or creative or nice, smooth way. So they- Oh, what the? There's underwater enemies now. Oh, that's spooky. Get out of here. So what they do instead is they just create these intermediary areas where it's just like, here's a series of hallways or a cave, and it just sort of joins different zones together. It's a basilisk. It's a basilisk, and there's a statue. Oh, and you can't get past the statue without a fragrant branch of yore, I don't think. How did you guys all manage to die? This place shouldn't be hard. Did you make a poopy? You guys make a... Oh, look at all these guys making poopies. They pooped all over the place. So when you touch a pool of blood, it just seems to summon guys all over the place to die. Like a whole bunch of people just show up everywhere. Not even necessarily from that specific pool. Alright, bye. What a dangerous basilisk. I don't know how I ever finished him off. It was so challenging. Man, this is a pretty effective weapon. I'm on board. So I can't use this thing, right? A statue blocks your way. And you can't break statues. How do you get past statues in this game? That's a new mechanic, more or less. Or is it? Do you just use fragrant branches of yore? Is that the same thing? I think it is. They're probably trying to increase the usefulness of fragrant branch of yore because in the original game, you would quickly, like, if you did them in the right order, you'd quickly run out of fragrant branches of yore. I mean, you'd quickly run out of things to use them on for the most part, and they weren't such a big deal. Okay, so now we have two statues blocking paths to play areas that we've been able to access before in the original game, but now they're blocked off, which means there might be a tough enemy back there, and there might be a special item that's worth getting. So, mental note. The place before No Man's Warf has a statue, and the tutorial area has a statue. So this is normally where you find Lucatiel. For the first time, I believe. But there could be something new. Lucatiel's not here. Oh no. Lucatiel might be gone because... I'll rest, and maybe she'll spawn. Hello? Nope, she didn't spawn. She may have warped ahead because I've already accessed the Lost Bastille. I was able to access the Lost Bastille via Beanpole required ahead, Monster ahead, Tri-Skeleton, but Skeleton. I've already accessed Lost Bastille, which is the next place she goes to. She may have just skipped ahead as a result. So this place is nasty. It has a lot of holes and things like that. It can go poorly for me. So let's be careful here. Fire, why? Oh, look at that. There's a little torch area. Oh, look at that. There's a monster trying to murder me in my face. Trying to murder my face. Ow. Rude. So I'm going to go ahead and run back to the bonfire. Not to use it. I'm not resetting it because I got hit once or anything like that. But if they're going to give me the opportunity, let's light this place up. I enjoy opportunities to continually light up zones in this game. Because it just looks nice. The lighting, even though the lighting engine largely didn't tend to look like what it was supposed to look like in the original E3 demo or whatever, it still looks pretty sweet to oh god, it's a doggy. It's a little mean little doggy. Oh no. Stab him in the face. I'm taking some hits here. That's not ideal at all. Oh god, where did he come from? I didn't see him at all. Hello friend? Ow. Hello? That's nice to meet you. Nice to meet you, sir. Oh, please dodge out of the way. Oh, goddammit. I need to get into the rhythm of just how long that animation is. Oh, wow, that was a slow attack. There we go. There's the parry I was going for. Get out of my face. I was totally ready to parry him, but then he did a brand new attack. Not necessarily new to the game, but just new to, like, as in, like, he hadn't used it a second ago. Alright, so yeah, two enemies came out of the darkness. All the more reason to light this place up. Another good thing... Ow. It's like he knew exactly where I was gonna go. It's almost like there was an obvious torch there. So, this is actually a neat zone to add a bunch of torches to along the way to let people light up everywhere. Because, oh, there's a guy coming up, isn't there? Oh god. Pressed the wrong button there. Oh shit, I'm not in power stance is what's going on here. Oh god, they're shooting me with fireballs. Just need to go over here for a second and get a little bit of space because everyone's being a dick and I just want to have fun. Alright, they're trying to shoot me with fire, aren't they? Alright. Oh god, he followed me really far with that attack. Very rude. Alright, I'm in power stance mode. Because fuck this guy. Roll! And kill! And finish him! There we go. That went poorly. Fucking radiant life gem, why not? I don't care anymore. It's fine. We're fine! So that went bad fast because I messed up. I wasn't in power stance mode, so when I got to that guy, I pressed the button for the two-handed attack, and instead I just sort of awkwardly... Oh, god damn it, this guy's great aim, and now he's dead, so I'll never aim again. Fuck that guy, I don't feel bad about him. Oh, that guy has less good aim, apparently. Way to go. I'm just gonna wait for these guys to come right on out here. Or they're not gonna come out. Oh, wow, that was some... It's an interesting trajectory. I don't think that's how jumping works. Any surprises behind me? There could be something cool around here. So I'm gonna keep an eye out for surprises. Anyone gonna come bursting out of there? No. Alright. Anything cool in here? Not a trap? Not a trap. Titanite shard. Alright, I can use that to upgrade. No, I can't use that to upgrade. My weapon requires... Does my weapon currently require large titanite? So I don't need titanite anymore unless I want to upgrade my armor. Soul of the Proud Knight, that should be another 2,000 experience. Oh, there's a torch up here too. I like that they've expanded the number of torch locations. That's sweet. Cause I always liked the torch lighting mechanic in this game. It's really good in this game's equivalent of Blight Town, the gutter, which is a super dark area. So you practically, or at least the intention was that you basically needed a torch to even play through the zone, but they kind of bitched out on the lighting and made the original Dark Souls 2 too bright. So you could just kind of just walk through it and you could still see, it was just a little less easy to see, but it didn't force people to use a torch instead of a shield the way that I think it was meant to. And we're getting closer to that territory in this game, because we're actually much more at risk of not being able to see around us now. I see you guys. I see you. I know you're coming for me. And, oh god! Guess who wasn't in power stance mode? There we go. That's power stance. There we go! Now we're learning with rapiers, and my weapons are about to break. Let's swap them real quick. There we go. By swapping the weapons, I changed my dominant weapon, which sort of offloads the rate of durability loss, which should hopefully help out with the fact that I'm already breaking my weapon, even though we just started the zone, because they still can't program... From Software still doesn't know how to program PC games, apparently. It's actually genuinely dark. I'm gonna go ahead and grab a torch. I could make out enough visually to be able to play through the zone without, without lighting a torch, but for the sake of our viewers, because the video is going to be dark, I'd rather just... Oh god, I didn't lock on them because he was still standing up. Oh, right. Don't do a strong attack. Strong attack is his parry. Unless you want to parry, of course. Hey, friend. You coming for me? You want a party? Oh, that was unsuccessful. Let's just go for the normal stabs. I don't need to try to parry every enemy here. They're going to be coming at me in groups. This is not a time for finesse. It's a time for evasive maneuvers. So, what do we have in here besides maybe an ambush? Dark pine resin. I can put that on my weapon to add, I believe, dark damage. Look at that guy wandering around, doesn't know how to get past boxes. His stupid head. Anything back here? Now we're good. Hey, Boxy. Boxy? What the? No! No! Where'd you come from? No! Where did you come? Where the fuck did that guy come from? Was he clearly on screen or was he invisible? Because we've established invisible enemies now, which I don't think were ever in this game originally, aside from New Game Plus area. If you fight the boss of this zone in New Game Plus, there was an invisible enemy, but I think before that there was no... I don't remember there being an invisible enemy ever. And that guy was very invisible. Alright, so one of the weird Darkling-type dudes used to be in here, and he's gone. They replaced him with that wandering dude, who's probably just meant to look stupid so that you try to walk up to him and get attacked by surprise Viking pirate dude. Not a good day for me. Oh, hello.
Oh, hello.
This whole zone's a little more dangerous now, isn't it? Thankfully, counterattack, because basically anytime you're in melee range of an enemy, they're probably starting an attack animation, so the fact that you get counterattack damage as a result is really handy. This is a doggy. There we go. Is he just gonna stand there? I hesitated for a moment, and he did not take advantage. Oh, you can drop down. Oh. I wonder if that enemy was supposed to ambush me, and he didn't, or something. So this is a good place to go to, because I believe you... Oh, Lucatiel, they moved you. They moved you, Lucatiel! You're not by the bonfire anymore, you're hanging out in this house that no longer has bad guys in it. Does it still have human effigies? Oh, I think that's where the ring of life protection used to be. Oh well. Hello, Lucatiel.
What is it? I don't know you, and you don't...
Alright, they did not change any of Lucatiel's dialogue. She's like, I'm Lucatiel of Mira, I'm here to find my brother. I am troubled to remember who I am. My face is all fucked up. That's my story. Alright, I'm probably gonna die horribly, and I will absolutely not succeed in any of my endeavors. Because I'm Lucatiel, I'm a fuck-up. I am enjoying lighting this place up. It's a nice touch. Ow. He tried to hit me. Oh god! It's a bad time to be picking up items. Bad time to be picking up items. Alright. How are we doing here? How are we doing here? Oh, nothing up here. It's just an empty room. Is there a secret door? Nope, doesn't seem like it. Alright, we've already been through there. I can go down there for an alternate path. Let's go ahead and light some stuff up. I like to light things on fire. Yes, it makes me feel pretty. You're dead? Doggy. Hi, doggy. Bye, doggy. Any surprises behind me? I'm digging the speed of this weapon. I'm not digging its really low durability. I'm gonna have to stock... Oh god, hello friend. Oh, hello multiple friends. Cool. I always wanted to be popular. Ow. That was a miss. For all of you keeping score. There we go. Where did you nasty little fucks come from? Oh, you're a peppy little spick fuck. So, is he gonna throw... Oh, he's throwing things at me. That's just rude. Alright, I'm gonna go deal with that guy. That ramp right next to me was the path forward, but I'm gonna go this way first. Oh, carts. Let's not attack them, that's durability to... Oh. Oh, look at that nasty. That's an oil... Oh, there's a lot of oil around here. If you get in that oil... Ow. Shit, quick heal. If you get hit by the oil, by breaking one of these things, or that guy's throwing stuff at me, you become very vulnerable to fire damage, and that's just bad for everyone. Well, not everyone involved. It's bad for you. Just you. No one else. They're fine with it. I'm hearing noises. I'm hearing nasty noises. Oh, God. You're here, too? Why is there so many of you? They want to hit you with oil because if they hit you with fire damage, your older half their attacks have fires. I don't think I have a Pharos Loxone, right? No. Oh no! Did I just get stuck down here? All right, large shoulder, proud knight. Let's try jumping back up. I can. Cool. Oh, I can't jump back up there. We have to take the long route. And by long route, I mean we have to walk up this one staircase. So not so much. Yeah, the oil makes you extra vulnerable to fire damage. It's the same mechanic you guys have been watching in my Bloodborne series, right? Right? You've been watching my Bloodborne series? Where if you get hit by oil, you're super vulnerable to fire damage. So it's like a damage buffer. Ow! Why? This has been a demonstration of the exact thing I was talking about. You're welcome. Alright, so I'm pretty sure what happened there is I was using a torch to light my path, and because I had a torch on me, that meant that I was extra vulnerable to the... Oh, that was my parry button, my bad. Oh god, there's so many of you. There's so goddamn many of you. Quick heal. I'm a die now. Okay, so it turns out everyone came to the party, so this is the end. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this series. This is the final episode. Oh god. Oh god. Just oh god in every way. Yeah, no. Hey, I parried that guy. Because I keep forgetting that's not strong attack, that's parry. I successfully parried someone in that chaos. So yeah, don't run past the bad guys. Increased draw distance and increased AI means they're gonna follow you. Dogs are mean. This guy's mean also. A multitude of things are actually mean in this game, it turns out. Hey, buddy. No. Parry. That actually worked. Blammo. So how many people are following me now? Oh god. Oh right, this is just a bunch of people in the zone regardless. I was confused because I did try to kill everyone this time and not leave people around. Oh god. Oh god, doggies, why? There's so many enemies right now. How do you even kind of try? There's a guy here too. Motherfucker. Oh, there's that guy. I see you now. Fuck you. Try to kill me again. I know your tricks. I'm about to... there goes all my hit points. Bye, hit points. I'll miss you. This is chaos. There's so many enemies in one spot. You're just being mean to me now, game. Doggy, why? I'm all out of Estus flasks. Ow! Why? Jesus Christ, I can't fucking move! No! Out of there! You're just being mean now. Attempt number 17,256. Thank you for watching, everybody. It's good to meet you. Can I lock onto the actual threat? Oh, god damn it. You're so persistent. How... They're so aggressive. I think half the zones between fights are now more dangerous than the actual boss fights now. Just gonna go out on a limb here and say that might be the case. Dog, die. Dog, stop being alive. No. Gosh, damn. Alright, this is becoming a problem. Finish! Oh, that's how you miss. That's how you miss. Oh, now I'm still... on top of everything else, I'm still getting hit by fucking fire arrows and shit from the background. There's... This encounter has like 10 enemies, right? Like... Someone else counted, I don't feel like it. But there's a... The number of enemies has increased significantly, I think. I'm lucky I'll just not wake these guys up. Or I can murder them all in the face! Gonna murder them all in the face. You deserve it. Ow. Is that instant karma coming at me right now? Oh no. Die. Gosh damn. Alright. I fucked up. That guy's still sleeping over there. I think there's an item over here. Are you a trap? Or am I just gonna get ambushed while opening you? There's the whole brigand set and the bandit axe. Hey buddy, you look tired. You look very... very tired. Are you a secret wall? No. I'm not sure where to check for secret walls. If they're gonna be the same places or new places. Hey, surprise, dude. Not letting you surprise me. Alright, what's up here? Effigies or something? What's in you? Titanite shard repair powder. Awesome. I need that for when my weapons break prematurely in a few minutes here. Buddy? What you doing there, buddy? Wanna come through that door, buddy? Alright, bye. Good job, you did it. He nailed it. Alright. Let's go ahead and swap my weapons. Because they are going to break at their current rate. Oh. Right. That guy's throwing shit. Ow. Just very impolite. I don't think I can even go this way yet. I was just kind of clearing through it just to show this zone and see how it was different or not different. Oh, is that Gavlan? They moved Gavlan. Interesting. Now Gavlan's hanging out. Now he's hanging out by the shortcut. They moved it. So they're moving NPCs a lot too. It's not just enemy placement. So Gavlan's now by the shortcut. We have to unlock that from the other side. So you have to go this way anyway. I was just going the other way to check. Oh, right. This part's not cleared in this particular playthrough. So I have to be careful about surprises. Let's light up our torch. Are they coming at me? Oh, that one is. That one is. Let's just go ahead and nip that one at the bud. You've been intercepted, sir. That guy's been stabbed in the face. It's kind of like being intercepted. I intercepted the signals between his brain and the rest of his body. So are the night creatures... Yes, they are. The night creatures are still here, but they're afraid of fire. Look at that big, scary fire I got. Oh, no. You better run away, because I got fire. Leave. Leave me be. Leave me. I'm gonna stab you now. I'm gonna stab you now. I'm gonna stab you now. I'm gonna stab you. Yeah. So they run away into this building. And I guess they only exist here now. There used to be a few of them elsewhere too, but they got rid of them. So I could go through there. Gavlan used to be up there. I think there might still be some worthwhile items up there. But this guy looks like he's gonna catch me off guard somehow. So let's just take care of him right off the bat. So up there is the bell I need to ring. Oh, was this cave here before? I'm bad at remembering such things, aren't I? Somewhere upstairs is going to be a bell I need to ring to unlock the next area. It'll bring in the ship that has the boss in it, and hopefully also give me the ability to. Are you gonna attack me? They are gonna attack me. Oh, you nasty fuck! How dare you? You're supposed to be more afraid of fire than that. Now I'm bleeding out. That's just mean. Alright. Nope. Oh, wow. Reach on that guy. He doesn't give a shit about my fire anymore. He stopped caring a long time ago. When they took away his 401k. Go down. So yeah, there's a limit to how much they're willing to run away from the fire. Probably because at some point I kind of pinned them in the corner. Let's see. If I hit the door, will it break down? I know they break this door down. There we go. He's gonna break this whole wall. Hey, buddy. How's it going? Oh, he is on the offense today. Let's reward his efforts. The series of quick stat. Oh, I don't have the stamina. Now I do. I think that's all. There might be one more upstairs. Any drops? Radiant life gem. That could come in handy. Just be careful and watch out for more. I think there's one upstairs. Yeah, there. Oh, there's two of them upstairs. Look at me not remembering things. They're so fucking creepy looking. Like the Cloverfield monster. Could one of you politely fall downstairs? Because that'd be handy for you to do. Oh god, there they are. There's the downstairs one, just like I wanted. So obedient. I have just enough stamina to hit them four times and finish them off more or less. Oh, there's his combo. Counter. There we go. That more or less works out for me. My stamina's fucked, though. I mean, not my stamina, my durability. I have a repair powder, though. That said, I'll likely open up the shortcut, and then, let's see, no enemies in here. Oh, this is the arrow trap. It's this one on the right, right? Yeah, it's that one. Now, that arrow's nasty. I have to be careful about how I roll away from that one, especially since I don't have any healing items right now, do I? I have a radiant life gem, I'm gonna have to pop that. All those souls I have. I could definitely level up a few times if I get back to town. Alright. Some of that's because I had to keep clearing the same zone a bit. Oh, it's poison. Did they replace it? Or maybe it's random. I think it might alternate between poison. I think some of the traps might alternate between arrow and poison regularly. Does this drop down to anything? Just back down. I wasn't sure if there was going to be a ledge with something on it. They could add things anywhere. So we got us a new sword. It used to be where Gavlan was. Now there's less reason to find Gavlan there, interestingly enough. Makes more sense, though. Now Goblin's in a better location as far as... Like, it's a more defensible position. and just generally makes more sense for a person to be at, as opposed to, I'm on top of this building full of monsters. Gavlan wheel, Gavlan deal. Gavlan wants soul, many, many soul. Come trade with me, even though you can't see me. So we rang the bell, so here comes the boss ship. Alright, I still have my fire torching, still have my torch running, so I should keep moving. But he'll come on in. Any things to light around here? Hey, this heads down into more dark, guys, doesn't it? Hey, buddy. Just gonna end you real quick, I hope you don't mind. There we go, good boy. Good boy. I especially like the part where you stopped breathing. Ow, no, you don't get to stab me. See, I killed him in three times. I killed him in only three hits that time because I counterattacked him because he started his attack animation and I ended it. Well, friend. I don't remember you being the- oh, bye. Oh, look at him hanging out. How long is he gonna stand there? How long were you planning on staying there? Get off my level. Bye. I don't know how long he was planning on hanging there. These guys are really good at just hanging on forever. There we go. Nice little bit of- oh god. What are you? Are you a ninja? Get out of my level. Oh, my rapier's gonna break. My rapier is going to break. And I already swapped weapons. Let's make them last a little longer. You see, I don't want to, use the mail breaker. There we go. Oh, that one's breaking too. Scimitar. Alright. Scimitar and mail breaker. What's the moveset on this thing like? It's also a rapier moveset. That's an interesting moveset. The scimitar is the weapon I started with. Mail breaker is something I picked up. So there's ninja type dudes hanging out around here. I don't like that, no one bit. I don't remember. I think you only encounter the ninja type dude once in the entire game. Oh, I dropped down. I can't access my own fire anymore, so I can't keep the train going unless there's a light source in here. Hello, friend. Whoop! You're being rude here. I think you only encounter the ninja guys like once in the entire game, and it's during the New Game Plus fight against the boss here. So if you haven't done that before, this is like a new experience for you. Let's see, there's a few things around here, so I'm gonna want this place. Let's watch out for poison. Ah, I'm poisoned. Okay, cool. I guess he's poisoned too, though, so that's neato. Oh god, I'm a die now. Bye! Ah, I didn't open the shortcut. It's gonna take a while to get back here. Haha.